Welcome then to the United Arab Emirates. Our F2 drivers are on the grid and we're moments away from lights out for the start of the Formula 2 Abu Dhabi race. Yas Marina Circuit is a 3.2-mile racetrack built on the man-made Yas Island. In addition to the 16 corners, it features two very long straights. Now these will be the drivers' main overtaking chances today into Turn 5 and Turn 7. Here is the grid for today's race, which will be starting shortly. A fantastic effort from Anne-Marie Cordiel yesterday puts him on pole position, with Felipe Drugovich alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Porcher, Hauger, Marino Sato, Williams, Awasa, Lawson, Vachon, Marcus Armstrong, Fittipaldi, De Ruvola, Ollie Caldwell, Frederick Vesti, Sargeant, Nissany, Calderon, Jack Doohan, Novalak, Phipps, Boshong, and Black Mamba. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track. I'm not the only one sitting here today who's looking forward to today's race. My friend and GP2 champion Davide Valsecchi is next to me, already on the edge of his seat, awaiting the start of the event. How's it going today?
Hello there, Alex. I'm great, thank you. And very excited to get started. I have a feeling we are in for a very special event today.
The formation lap gets underway for this, the Formula 2 race, and every driver will be looking to settle in for the race ahead, making sure the car is ready for battle once the lights go out. We are almost ready to start the Formula 2 race as the cars take their positions on the grid, with the drives and teams making their final preparations.
hasn't always been like that, though. In the 1950s, the average age of the drivers was 39, with 3 over the age of 60. Present since the very start of sport, Ferrari takes the number one spot for almost all constructor records in F1. It's the team with most world championships won, most Grand Prix wins, most race editions. This saw only 6 cars won. This was the infamous 2005 US Grand Prix. Sebastian Vettel holds the F1 record for the shortest time elapsed before picking up a penalty. He was caught speeding in the pit lane in practice for the 2006 Turkish Grand Prix almost immediately after he exited the garage, just 9 seconds of his F1 career. Let's hope we see a good effort from here today in recent times that he's fallen to somewhat of a midfield team. The last of the constructor won a world championship in 1998. Fast pit stops, some even approaching the sub-2 second mark. Well, that
And here's another to add to that prestigious list. It's the ultimate dream for any racing driver. We have a new Formula 2 world champion. It wasn't always plain sailing today, but a very important win nonetheless. Davide, what do you think made the difference here?
It was down to one thing: consistent pace over everyone else out there on the track. We could spend a great deal of time talking about race and tire strategy, what has occurred on the track, but at the end of the day, the difference here was down to simply being faster on track than everyone else. Amazing skill on show.
And as the adrenaline dies down after another eventful race, here come our top three out onto the podium. And now, let's take a look at the driver's standings. It's a good result for Amaury Cordiel, who extends his advantage at the top of the championship. Now then, Davide Valsecchi, who would you say was your driver of the day?
Lots of drivers impressed me today, Alex. But if I have to say one that impressed me most, it's Amaury Cordiel.
On to the teams, then. After all this drama, you would be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.